General Towns versus General Kwai.
Your tank rush is nothing compared to mine. This area was once fertile farmland. Soon your blood will make it fertile again.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Command & Conquer General's Shockwave. Welcome to the Tank General's Challenge. We are still playing as the Laser General. So let's get our base up and running. And capture these Aldarics here. There we go. And you can, you know, build me another power plant. We're going to need those sooner or later anyway. So we may as well get them now. There we go. Then let's get me that supply depot. And I'm going to build another one here for those supplies. Whether or not that's worth it, we'll see. And I probably shouldn't have done that before. I could afford another copter here, but alas, it doesn't really matter now. So yeah, you collect those supplies. I think that should be worth it because these guys should pay for themselves pretty quickly. But we'll see. Nope, can't afford that yet. We should be able to afford it soon. And there we go. In the meantime, let's just have you guys take over those Aldarics. They will be destroyed quickly, but they will pay for themselves until then. There we go, and here we go. Let's get another one of these then. And then let's get some defenses. Because we don't have anything at this point here. So, one of these here. I guess I give you a designation.
What's the story?
Here we come, General. I hope your defenses are on.
Actually, no, they're not. They're not up at all. But I think we have another moment here, so he's not going to come for us.
General, I need that oil derrick for my tanks.
Okay, you can come home. Upgrade you. Let's build another one of these right here. Yeah, we're going to build an entire network of these. That seems to work best. There we go. And we might need another power plant soon as well. And are they already attacking that? I suppose so. It's okay, so get another power plant here. Yet another one of these. And oh yeah, that power plant should be ready before we run out of power here. There we go. I guess you are. Oh yeah, they're destroying that now, but that's okay. So those are my guys, so you need to fear them. And more of you. And then we'll build an arms factory, possibly some artillery. You don't hide here, because otherwise I might forget where you're actually hanging out. Did you just destroy that? I think you did. What a shame. It's okay though.
Control rod upgrade complete.
Also one propaganda center for the... Oh, no, where are... damn it. Where are you guys when I need you? Doesn't really matter. So let's get an arms factory. Maybe one or two more power plants, because you never know when you need them. Let's fix you. I have to admit, these feel... they feel slightly underpowered. I do recall these being stronger, but maybe that's just me imagining that. So anyway, doesn't really matter all that much. We've got a nice network of stuff here. You, oh, there comes the Overlord. Let's see how that goes. Oh, they've got several Overlords. Let's try to fix you then. Okay, didn't manage to save that. It's okay. I'm going to replace you straight away. And you can actually engage this guy here just in case we need a distraction here. And there we go. So we still managed to pull that off. Okay. We need another one here, obviously. There we go. Build another power plant, and you guys can kind of hang around here.
Can you feel the thunderous song of approaching armor?
And there we go. And then let's get me. You can repair stuff here, and you can get me that strategy center, and I guess I can upgrade you. That's what I want. Essentially, these guys being shot so. Being attacked so hard that they don't even consider damaging anything before. Yeah, that's what I want, so. That will also save me repairs and stuff. So. Can get this airstrike here, which I like, so let's attack the propaganda center, because that means no overlords and no nuke silo. And propaganda center is on its way. It's nice. Let's build one more of these. We're going to need soon later anyway. And there we go.
Job for me. General, my forces outnumber yours. It's only a matter of behind now.
Yeah, they do actually outnumber. So let's get the range bonus. Let's get the money bonus. Let's get this. Because more damage for my lasers is always good, because lasers is pretty much the only thing I use here. And they're really like attack from this angle here. Did I actually blow that up? Nope, I did. That you just have to rebuild it. That's okay. We'll still slow them down for a while. Boom, dead. And then they're probably going to run out of money soon, out of steam. You can still harvest this. There's no need to. If they just stack up down there, then they're just going to block one another, and that's not actually going to improve the speed at which I get stuff here. So new supply lines are on their way. That upgrade takes a while because it's expensive. But that was to be expected. And zip. I'm not going to use air units against this guy. He's got too much that can't be laser defense zapped. And what else can I get? This one here. Do I want this? This kind of feels weak. Let's get the artillery. That's so awesome. One should always have railgun artillery if railgun artillery is available. Yeah, let's get more of these here. That's sweet, sweet money. Oh dear, air units, but it's okay. Though these are surprisingly sturdy, but it's not that bad. Okay, heavy lasers for us. What else do I want? Probably more of these drop zones. I guess that team got shot down. Well, Bravo team is no longer around, that's okay. Don't actually need you then anymore.
Any more projects?
And goodbye. So, that's said and done. Any more projects? Yeah, we do have some more projects, like more drop zones.
Soon the field will fill with tanks. My tanks.
And I think this field is soon going to completely run out of steam and not have any tanks anymore, because that just seems to be part of this guy's script for some reason. But let's just not question that. I'm also going to build a super weapon, because you never know. Yeah, you can notice that these are stronger. This guy here doesn't even reach us anymore.
What's the story?
I'm saying this guy. As if it was always the same guy, which obviously isn't the case. And dead. Let's watch that from up close. There we go. Oh. Kudos to these guys for just continuing to run in here. I wouldn't do that. And oh, can't actually afford that, so don't know why I was probably clicking on that, but never mind. And does our supply line bonus actually apply to the drop zones? I think it does. I mean, it does apply to all directs, so it seems to apply to everything. Even though I don't think it applies to other faction structures when you have that. Yeah, hackers don't get a bonus like that. Then again, 20% would be too low anyway, so let's not worry about that. But let's get more of these and zoom out all the way. Well, not quite all the way, but this level of zoom here is what I need. Everything else is a little bit too close. Too closely zoomed in. So more
good area. Always ready.
Of these.
Nice base, General. Care to surrender it?
And yeah, we still have enough power.
Made in the US
and out of resources here, but that's okay, because our unlimited money options are right here.
Clocked
That particle cannon will never live to fire on me.
Oh, we'll see about that. So, is he doing anything? Nope. Let's just hang around here. I like how he has this dedicated advanced ECM tank troop just to blow up those two Alderaaks. He said he needed for his tanks. And let's get a couple more of these, and then we should have all the cash we need to build all the tanks we need. Anything else I want? Drone armor, human training. Yeah, I guess we. I suppose we can get all of that.
This spells your doom, General.
New construction.
And yeah, one more, then we're good. Then we can probably build a second arms factory. Could also get an airfield, but as said before, he has too much bullet-based stuff that can't be zapped down, so I'm not going to bother with that all that much. Yeah, let's actually get this one here. Pff, carrier strike. I suppose I can get that. And there we go. Yeah, that's it.
We have completed the advanced training.
And more UN supplies. Thank you very much, United Nations, for financing this war here, which is rather questionable, but I'm not going to question it.
We're in your base, General. Your defenses were inadequate.
No. Yeah, his clips are completely random. I mean, it's not as bad as the Swap Weapon General. Swap Weapon General is just talking all the time, and nobody knows what she's talking about. But for some guys, for most general, it kind of makes sense. And he's not making generic messages. Yeah, let's not bother with that. We're not fighting the infantry general. In fact, we never will, because he's not in this challenge. He does have his sound files, but he doesn't have dummied out. Let's actually get the MOAB upgrade. Yeah, let's get that. And suppose we could attack stuff here. Yeah, let's just attack this. Let's carry. Actually, let's carry our strike. Those guys here.
Select target.
That's actually what the carrier strike could be good for. And this, I guess, theoretically, you can shoot that down, but it seems to be difficult. Also, this doesn't really like the area that's close to the water, where we could have an actual aircraft carrier. But let's not question that. So, still kind of weak, but it only costs you a single point. So I guess that's fair. For a single point, it's probably not that bad. Though I want a lot more of these guys here, because they're awesome. Then we need some anti-air, because you never know when you...
MOAB upgrade complete.
When you meet some helixes or so. How expensive are you? Only 900, that's not actually that bad. You are slightly more expensive. And these guys also have some sort of continuous laser cannon, which looks pretty cool. And that's important too.
How much longer can you survive such losses, General? Perhaps it is time to consider surrender.
Select target.
Ah, we could mob this here. Oh, they already... How fast are they building that? Never mind. Just send you after that. It's good enough for me. And you're still building these guys here. You actually need a lot of drop zones until you really, really have unlimited money. But once I... What was that? That was a sound clip I didn't really hear all that often. In fact, I didn't quite guess it. Let me know where you are.
I fear this will end you, General.
Never mind. So you guys aren't even. Let's get two more while we're waiting for those guys, and then we're good to move out, I suppose. You can just join in here, even though that's probably not just going to get you killed. But who cares? Let's actually get you radiation suits, because who knows how many reactors we're going to blow up here. And then we're just going to march into his base and be done with it. Yeah, this is good enough. Actually, you can become Alpha Team, because you are artillery, but you... Only your low rate of fire prevents you from being some sort of super tank. Which it kind of has to, otherwise this wouldn't be balanced in the slightest. Even though I have the feeling these guys are already overpowered. Now I have to give these guys here drones separately, but that's okay too. And I guess I'm going to build a couple more of these, just in case. Alpha and Bravo team fail. So, time to smoke out those guys over there. Should already be damaged, with no means to repair themselves. And then we're going to kill... Oh, except for promotions. And dead. Yeah, with promotions, these guys are totally awesome, because then their rate of fire becomes crazy high. And this guy already is double promoted, isn't that sweet? Not even going to use my spore weapon, I don't really need it. Yeah, actually, I am, as a matter of fact. Just saying, so. And... yeah, we're coming for you. This guy, if this guy's kept up his assault, that would be a decent challenge. But he's actually easier. He doesn't seem to be able to his nuke silo unless you wait forever, really. Let's just kill that, just in case. And that makes him a lot less dangerous, because it means you don't need to rush for two of your super weapons, depending on what you have. Okay, you be a little bit careful here. Boom. Ram the turrets. Doesn't stand a chance, because it's immobile. I also like how this looks like. There's just this beam here. I know, well, since it's a... from what I understand about railguns is that they use projectiles that are accelerated using a probably magnetic field, so they don't have any backlash, because it's not like the, let's say, like a classic gun where you have a... well, you've got a pipe, you've got an explosion, and you push something out, but the explosion kind of goes into all directions, so you might dislocate your shoulder. Oh! Oh, another guy. And dead. I think one of... oh, there's several guys now. I think one of these generals actually has pilot training. It might be the Air Force general that you can essentially build pilots to have your guys promoted, which can be... could be... so having a couple of elite guys could be cheaper than having a lot of guys that are not elite. Or alternatively, you could also have space constraints. Let's say if you bring them in via airlift, you might want to have your guys to be as powerful as possible. And here we go. Yep, these guys here can destroy everything. Like this airfield here. Well, it doesn't stop your tanks because it's an airfield, but I think we're doing well enough. Equipped with laser rifles, and I like that they can shoot through stuff. That is so great. It's like shooting over stuff, except better. You also don't shoot into obstacles accidentally. That's nice too. Let's actually get the Humvee a proper laser. Zip. And yeah, with all upgrades and stuff, these guys become quite powerful. Could give some Hellfire drones, makes it even more powerful, but I never quite do that. Also, I think these are quite expensive. Yeah. I think they cost like 1,200, so they are very expensive. But apparently they're powerful too. So let's just laser zap this part of his base, just to speed this up a little bit, and then we're done. Yeah, just be enough lasers to beat his overlord. That was the only, like, sorta kinda critical moment here, but even that wasn't too big of a deal. Boom. At least, using these guys is so much fun. It's just so satisfying, and they look so cool and stylish. And everything's out of power, awesome. And he's not building anything, despite having at least some money. He's got 5 elite hackers. That does give you some income. And now they're all dead. Then you blow that up, and I think for some reason you don't need to blow up his supply center or his hacking center. There's some buildings that for some reason don't count. Oh, there's actually... I don't know where you came from, but never mind. Never mind. And that should be it. Yep, it is it indeed. Don't know where those lorries are going, but doesn't matter because they just exploded.
You may have defeated my tanks, General, but the Tigress will crush you like an insect.
Nope, because I already crushed her. Thanks for watching. I'm going to make that joke every time. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.